good time. Good
time. He's pretty excited about it.
I'm not gonna lie, I didn't see that coming.
Took guts. Took guts.
Please rise. Gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
The congregation may be seated. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dearly beloved, we're gathered here together in the sight of God and before his people to witness the union of this man and this woman in the holy estate of matrimony. This is an honorable estate instituted and blessed by God in paradise before humanity's fall into sin. In marriage, we see a picture of the communion between Christ and his bride, the church. Our Lord blessed and honored marriage with his presence and first miracle at Cana in Galilee. This estate is also commended to us by the Apostle Paul as good and honorable. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into inadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for mutual companionship, help, and the support that each person ought to receive from the other, both in prosperity and in adversity. Marriage was also ordained so that man and woman may find delight in one another. Therefore, all persons who marry shall take a spouse in holiness and in honor, for God has not called us to impurity, but in holiness. God also established marriage for the procreation of children, who are to be brought up in the fear and instruction of the Lord, so that they may offer him their praise. For all these blessed reasons, God has established the holy estate that Zach Coleman and Melissa Topeka wish to enter, and they desire our prayers as they begin their marriage in the Lord's name and with his blessing. Zach and Melissa, a reading from Genesis chapter 2. The Lord God formed the man of dust from the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living creature. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make a helper fit for him." So out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every bird of the heavens and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all livestock and all the birds of the heavens and every beast of the field, but for Adam there was not found a helper fit for him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. And the man said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." And a reading from 1 Corinthians 13 about true love. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. So now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love. Zach and Melissa, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. It certainly is a beautiful day where we give thanks to God. We couldn't have asked for better weather. It's a touch warm, so it's okay to move around. Don't lock your knees. But it is a gorgeous day, made even more beautiful by your love. You know that quote, "This is the day the Lord has made"? That's from Psalm 118. And in the church, we use that psalm on Easter morning when we celebrate, when we rejoice, when we give thanks for the bridegroom, Jesus Christ, and his love for his bride, the church. Now, today's not Easter, but this too is a day of celebrating, a day of rejoicing, because what you two have and what you two pledge to each other today is a beautiful thing. Melissa, I've known Zach for a few years, not since he was a baby or anything like that, but a few years. I even went on at least one mission trip with him. I don't remember if there were any more, but what I learned about Zach is that he lives his faith. He puts it in action. He's a man of principle. He wants what is good and right for himself, for you, for those around him. He's a hard worker. He's smart. He's got good friends and good family. And probably after this service, these good friends and family over here will pull me aside and say, "What you said about Zach, well, that was good, but let me tell you a few more things about him." And Zach, you have a wonderful lady by your side. I haven't known her as long as I've known you, but I know she's a nurse, and I'm married to a nurse, and so I know that she's strong, and I know she can put up with a lot of garbage, but don't put her through garbage on purpose. I know that she's smart, she's compassionate, she is kind, she's a hard worker too, and I know she is a good fit for you. Your cake at the rehearsal last night said, "The hunt is over." Well, I suppose hunting animals is still something you enjoy, but hunting for the one God has provided. Today is a good day that the Lord has made, and we rejoice in it. I want you to think for just a few minutes about what was different. What's different today about your relationship than it was yesterday? Yesterday you were pledged to each other. Today you belong to each other. Yesterday you were a nice couple. Today you become one. Yesterday you spent time together, but today is a beginning, a new start, the first day of the rest of your lives together. Yesterday you would laugh together or be sad together, but today you begin to shoulder one another's burdens and double each other's joys. Yesterday you would experience life together, but today you live in the fullness of God's design for man and wife. Yesterday you were in love. Today you begin a lifelong true love, bound together in the powerful love of God. And that's why we celebrate, because this wedding is a wonderful thing. Now, lots of people get excited about weddings. Our whole society, our whole culture finds weddings exciting, exhilarating, romantic. Not as many people get excited, though, about marriage. But marriage is a beautiful gift of God, and it's something to rejoice in. God invented it. God blessed it. In marriage, you two have a lifelong friendship, romance, becoming one together, raising a family together, if the Lord wills. Marriage is a lifelong blessing. And when you two have true love for one another, well, that's the building block for family, and family is the block that builds society, and all your family and friends and those around you are blessed if you two love one another, have a true love for one another. Now, true love comes from God. He defines it because God is love. We heard these descriptions in 1 Corinthians 15. Love is patient and kind. It doesn't insist on its own way. It's not rude. And this is something that the world doesn't understand, because when the going gets tough, there are many people out there who don't know what to do. I read a funny description about marriage. That was this. Marriage is when you agree to spend the rest of your life sleeping in a room that's too warm next to someone who's sleeping in a room that's too cold. And I find that amusing because it describes my marriage. I'm always warm, and I wonder how it's physically possible for my wife to have such cold hands. But we've been married 15 years, and she is a blessing to me, and I thank God for her every day. But because you are different people, and because none of us are perfect, sometimes marriage is work. It's hard work. It's easy to start thinking about what you want to get out of a marriage, and it's hard to think about what you want to put into a marriage. But that's what I want to encourage you and all married couples out there today. What will you put into your marriage? Marriage is the best work there is. There are many rewards, a life of blessing, and you will have each other for all those days, the good days, the bad days, the busy days, the calm days, the thrilling days, the boring days. You will have each other. And you will have God, because Jesus promises to be with you, and he says, as I have loved you, so you also love one another. So that's an instruction, but it's also a promise that he will be with you. The instruction is keep him there. Rely on his love. Rely on his forgiveness and his strength every day for everything that life throws at you. But the promise is also there when he says, I will be with you always. He's loved us so much that he laid down his life on the cross so we can be forgiven and reconciled to God and to one another. And so he promises that he will put this same love in you. So you can rejoice in that love always. Be thankful for the wedding gift that he gives you today, each other. Celebrate your marriage, cherish it, protect it, enjoy it every day, because you have a love that's made in the heart of God. This is a day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Zach and Melissa, now you will make your promises to God. Zach, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony as God ordained it? Will you nourish her and cherish her as Christ loved his body, the church, giving himself up for her? Will you love and honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain united to her alone so long as you both shall live? If so, then say, I will.
I will.
Melissa, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony as God ordained it? Will you respect and cherish him just as the church responds to Christ? Will you love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain united to him alone so long as you both shall live? If so, then say, I will.
I will.
You two may now face each other as you make your promises to one another. Zach, you can repeat after me. Hi, Zach.
Hi, Zach.
Take you, Melissa.
Take you, Melissa.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death parts us.
Until death parts us.
According to God's holy will.
According to God's holy will.
And I pledge you my faithfulness.
And I pledge you my faithfulness.
I'm Melissa.
I'm Melissa.
Thank you, Zach.
Thank you, Zach.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death parts us.
Till death parts us.
According to God's holy will.
According to God's holy will.
And I pledge you my faithfulness.
And I pledge you my faithfulness.
Almighty Father, you have generously created all things to serve us for our good. Send your blessing upon this couple who shall wear these rings as a constant reminder of their marital fidelity. Grant that by your mercy they may live gladly and faithfully in this holy estate. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a pledge and token.
As a pledge and token.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a pledge and token.
As a pledge and token.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
Of wedded love and faithfulness.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Now that Zach Coleman and Melissa Topeka have committed themselves to each other in holy matrimony, have given themselves to each other by their solemn pledges, and have declared the same before God and these witnesses, I pronounce them to be husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. And the Almighty and gracious God abundantly grant you his favor and sanctify and bless you with the blessing given to Adam and Eve in paradise, that you may please him in both body and soul and live together in holy love until your life's end. Amen. Zach, you may now kiss the bride. At this time, Zach and Melissa will assemble the Unity Cross, a beautiful sculpture that Zach made, which they will display in their home to remind them of the covenant they are making today. In Genesis chapters 1 and 2, as we just heard, God created man in his image, male and female he created them. He formed man from the ground and blew life into him, and he became a living being. But it was not good for man to be alone, so God made a wife for Adam. Zach, if you would take the groom's cross. This cross, which will be the outer shape of the cross, represents the strength, the leadership, and the protection of the man. The book of Ephesians reminds husbands to love their wives as Christ loved the church, totally and completely giving himself for her. Melissa, if you would take the bride's cross. Genesis tells us that when God made a woman, he made the man to fall asleep and took part of his side, and he built it, made it into a woman. She was taken from man. The bride's piece of the unity cross represents the beauty and complementary nature of the woman, someone fit for man. Her cross is designed to be beautiful and to be placed within the outline of the groom's cross, representing the two becoming one. You may place them together. To complete this sculpture, we are using three nails to hold it together. These nails remind us of Jesus, who died on the cross and rose for us, for no greater love has anyone than the love of Jesus, who laid down his life for us. The number three also reminds us of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, three persons yet one God, showing God's place in this covenant and the security, completeness, and unity that only he can give.
There goes nothing.
Scripture tells us that a three-stranded cord is not easily broken, and so we have Zach and Melissa, and of course, your God is with you. Also in Matthew 19, Jesus quotes Genesis saying, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh." And Jesus then adds, "So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." So Zach and Melissa, may this unity cross ever be a symbol in your home of the unity and love you have in him. Amen. We bow our heads in prayer. Almighty everlasting God, our heavenly Father, grant that by your blessing, Zach and Melissa may live together according to your word and promise. Strengthen them in faithfulness and love toward each other. Sustain and defend them in every trial and temptation. Help them to live in faith toward you, in the communion of your holy church, and in loving service to each other, that they may ever enjoy your heavenly blessing. Lord, look with favor upon all the homes of our land. Embrace husbands and wives, parents and children in the arms of your love, and grant that each in reverence to Christ fulfill the duties you have given. Bless our homes, that they may ever be a shelter for the defenseless, a fortress for the tempted, a resting place for the weary, and a foretaste of our eternal home with you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Zach and Melissa, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. You may face the congregation. I have been invited to announce that as Zach and Melissa process out the aisle, you can shower them with those flower petals you were given when you came in and took your seat. After the whole bridal party exits, Zach and Melissa will return to greet you and dismiss you row by row. It is now my honor and my privilege to introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Zach Coleman.
Make it rain.
Make it rain.